All right, it is time. For those that don't know, I am Jim Michael from Jim Reviews, here today with my review on a shoe that people have been asking for, I don't know, a month, 2 months. People have been asking me, Jamie, do you have this shoe? Have you tried this shoe? And I'm like, yes, I have. And after a month and a half or so, I'm here with my final thoughts on the ASICS NOVABLAST. First off, that's a horrible name, but let's get into it. Perfect. The NOVABLAST is ASICS' attempt to be modern, to be edgy, to kind of get with the times, to get all the slack of being too old school, too traditional, too boring, but this is everything but that.
About that.
This shoe is, I would say, a fun shoe. But why is it a fun shoe? Typically, I'll start off with the upper, but get to the point, the upper is a mesh, it's breathable, it's nice, it fits really well, true to size, I had no issues with it. It's a little, you know, the tongue's a little weird as far as kind of being a wide tongue that's not attached. They probably could have made it an attached tongue like the other, like, Epic Reacts and all those kind of shoes. The tongue is not attached, but doesn't change anything. I just thought it'd be a cool thing to do. The heel cup is actually just good. And by that, I mean it's not, like, super sturdy and super stiff. This is, like, a normal heel cup. It's, like, not too hard, not too stiff. Feels like a neutral shoe. And that's the big thing about ASICS. Sometimes I can't tell the difference between their stability shoes and the neutral shoes as far as the uppers. They always seem a little stiff in the heel cup. This one is like normal, which is, to me, an upgrade. If I want a shoe that's lightweight, neutral, and bouncy, just you don't gotta add all the extra stiffness, all the extra support. You don't want all that. The people buying this shoe want what they want. And that goes into the midsole. So here we have the Flight Foam Blast. And man, it is a blast. Was that kind of corny?
No, that's good.
It is all the buzzwords. Bouncy, energetic, responsive, energy return, all those. But it actually is that. If you're someone who loves the Epic Reacts, the Infinity Reacts, any of those bouncy shoes, this shoe takes those shoes to the next level. Like, this is a lot of bounce. It's a little more squish. As a matter of fact, when I first tried this shoe on, I was like, wow, that is not what I was expecting from my ASICS. The compression I got out of the midfoot here, so a lot of shoes have cushioning in the heel. Obviously, there's a good amount of cushioning right here. But as far as that midfoot cushioning, it was by far the most. So if you're someone who like midfoot strikes and you really tear that metatarsal area up, you're like, man, I want something with more cushion in that area. I think this is it. Like, for midfoot strikers, forefoot strikers, you're gonna feel a big difference between this shoe and other neutral style shoes. And it has that bounce too. But if you have a run that you really wanna go fast, you wanna be in control and really just responsive and have that high turnover, I would say that's where it kinda, maybe kinda productive. It's gonna feel good for long runs, but as far as like just being a speed shoe, this ain't it. You got better options from ASICS. I would go with the Evo Rider, something with more of a former responsive feel. This has more of a bouncier, cushier feel. So if you reach the shoes like the Glycerins and the 1080s, like the high cushioning shoes, this is like that, but bouncy and lighter. I say pretty much it's like Epic React with more cush. Do I like it? I do. The cushioning's nice. You get outsole rubber. So I can see they put it on the perimeter of the outsole. So you got a little flex here. Look at that, an ASICS that flexes. Tell me it ain't so. The rubber so far has been durable. I mean, I could definitely see some wear where I'm like, okay, I could kind of see it's getting a little bald there, but eventually we all go bald, unfortunately. Or some of us, not Megan. But yeah, that's boring stuff. Durability is fine. I'm glad they put some rubber on here because sometimes with shoes, if you don't have any rubber, it gets all nasty and kind of functionally it's still fine, but aesthetically it's nice to have a shoe that looks good. I'm liking this shoe. What do I not like about this shoe? I like the tongue. The tongue just seems like it could be less, maybe like not so wide, and it just seems extra, like excess tongue. too much tongue. We just met. But yeah, I really can't think of anything I don't like about the shoe. I feel like it fits the purpose. And that's the key. Like, is it the perfect shoe? No. But for the purpose of being a neutral, cushier, bouncier option, I think ASICS got one. I think this is the first ASICS where I say, oh, it's kind of cool. It looks funky. This whole cutout and like the whole like cutout into the midsole design and this extra piece here to kind of coming out of the shoe, maybe it adds more stability to me. It looks like, you know, Nike does it. I'm not a fan of how it looks. I'd rather it just look normal without the cutout. So if you guys can change that for next year, I would appreciate it. But you know, that's just all aesthetics, I guess. If there's some functional reason for it, by all means, keep doing what you're doing. The shoe feels good. But I am very proud to say that ASICS, you're doing well. The Meta series, from the Glide Ride, the Evo Ride, the Meta Racer, links down below for those reviews. They're doing great. And this one is just another one. For 130, I'm not too mad. I'm not. This shoe could be 150 and I'll be like, oh, I'll probably still rock with it for 130. I'm like, all right, cool. You're in that New Balance Rebel range. You're in that Brooks Ghost range. You're in this. I'm picking this over the Brooks Ghost. The Rebels are more responsive. So I feel like if you had a shoe like that and you want a cushier option that wasn't too heavy, here you go. This is a mid-range weight. Nothing crazy light, nothing crazy heavy. It's just mid-range, but the bounce makes it feel lighter than what it is. But yeah, that's my thoughts on the shoe. I know the shoe's been out for about a month or so, 2 months. I'm a little late to the game, but you know, you guys have my back. What do you guys think about the shoe? Is it good? Is it a flop? Do you like it? Do you not like it? Be honest. I mean, I know I'm MAGA. I'm all MAGA all the time, but you know, you guys don't have to always agree with me, unless you want to. But if you could, give this video a thumbs up regardless. If you hate this video, give it a thumbs down twice. And with that said, be sure to stay in school. Don't do drugs, and if you can, keep it tight. And I don't want to hear any comments saying, like, Jamie, my school is shut down. I don't care. Just find somewhere to go to school. Go online school. Go homeschool. Just find something. Just stay educated. Stay doing something. Don't be at home during the quarantine playing Call of Duty Warzone. But if you want to play Warzone, you can add me on the Xbox Live. You know, we can team up. Maga.